Yeah, welcome back to Friday's Transfer Show. And as promised, we have been joined by Alex Levak, the agent of Ben White. Alex, thanks so much for giving up your time to join us this evening. I just want to start off, first of all, with what you've made of the transfer window so far as a whole, particularly because this has felt like a different one with all of the issues with profit and sustainability rules as well.
It's definitely made it more interesting. And there's been kind of like two windows, hasn't there? There's been the one that's the 31st of June. And obviously the one coming up, or the 30th of June, sorry, 30th of June. And then obviously the one now. And I think you can see from this week, it's really starting to hot up. And there's a lot of bigger deals happening, a lot of larger transactions. And it's definitely becoming more exciting now.
From a personal viewpoint, have you had a busy one?
We've had a fairly busy one, but we keep it quite small and manageable. The way that we represent our players is from like a 360 view. So we cover everything in their lives. So if we had 100 clients, it'd be impossible to look after them properly. So we represent them in a holistic 360 manner. So we are very manageable and we're not like stressed and we don't have to get deals done. We haven't got shareholders to answer to. So we make sure the deals are done to the right places at the right time.
Alex, we've alluded to it before, but because of maybe the Euros and the Copa America, we think it's going to be busy. Did you expect it because of maybe the international tournaments as well?
Definitely. There's always kind of goes on hold a little bit. You get the early surge where there's some deals happening, but then the tournaments are there. Everything goes on hold a bit. And then now I think we're going to see 3 weeks of some really interesting stuff.
And Alex, what would you say is the biggest challenge for an agent representative in today's football?
I think the biggest challenges we face is it's really saturated market. So there's a lot of agents out there now. Some purport to be agents but aren't really doing much business. Some very good, some not so good. And I just think that everyone's tapping your players up. So you've just got to be comfortable in your relationship with your players, make sure you're on top of the job, doing the right things for the right reasons. And you keep hold of them.
Just picking up on that, sorry, Michael, you said that, you know, you've got maybe competition from agents tapping up players.
Sure.
So when you say, when you said before, you've got a more holistic view with regard to your players and you've got a smaller amount of players not having to answer to anyone, does that help with the trust? And then they will effectively come to you and say, this guy's trying to tap me up here. I just want to let you know.
Yeah. For sure, because when you've got a smaller amount of clients and you genuinely care, which we do genuinely care, then you can't fake that. You know, you get that feeling, and I think that they know that we are trying our best and doing what's best for them. You know, for us, money is a byproduct of what we do. It's not our sole focus.
You look after Ben, but it's not just about securing a good transfer for him, is it? Or just a good new contract. There's a lot more to it than that, isn't there?
Absolutely. I've represented Ben for over 10 years now. So we've built that real foundation of trust with himself and his family. So basically, we manage most of Ben's off-the-field life. So what we want to do is basically take everything off of his hands. So all he's got to worry about is training, matches, and then he frees up his time to spend with his family and his closest friends and the people he wants to see.
Alex, we had Luke Dowling on earlier on in this week and he was giving us the perspective of a transfer window and deals between clubs from a sporting director perspective. Mm-hmm. From your perspective, from a player's representative, can you talk us through layman's terms, a deal? You know, how does it happen chronologically? How does it work? When do you get involved?
It's hard because every deal is different. Some you can obviously prep for and it's done over a period of time. Some are very reactional, depending on like contract length, depending on what fees are being asked. Is there a buyout? So there's so many different variables that can contribute to a transfer. So it's really hard to give you a specific kind of play-by-play for each transfer. But I'll give you an example. Last year, we had a player, he's an international player, and he was in a club in England. And basically, we didn't have anything last 4 days of the window. So myself and one of the guys that works with us, we were camped in our office, sleeping on the sofa, literally every waking minute, hour, on the phone, trying to get something done. So one night we'd go to bed and there was nothing on the table. You wake up the next day, there was two or three things on the table, and it's just mayhem.
So you're actually phoning the clubs. Who are you speaking to? You're speaking to sporting
directors, contacts at clubs, because obviously you've got various different decision makers. But yeah, it can be, those last few days can be absolutely wild. And I think that's the part that a lot of people don't see. And when you actually do care, you're putting in that time.
Mm. Obviously, agents don't always get the best press generally, but why do you think that is? And is it fair?
I think any industry where there's obviously a lot of money involved, you're going to attract good, bad and indifferent. And I think agency is the same. There's some very good ones. There's some not so good ones. I mean, the way that I've operated, I've been in business since 2000, and it's always been key to me to build a clean reputation. And I'd like to believe that if you ask most people within football, they would say, first and foremost, I'm a decent human being. So that's how we try to differentiate ourselves from the others.
Decent golfer as well, by the way.
Wouldn't say that.
tell us about the process of when you got Ben White from Brighton to Arsenal. He signed the new contract. You mentioned sporting director there. I've had the pleasure of speaking to Edu, who seems like a really good guy. Mm. What's it like when you deal with decent sporting directors in the process of a transfer and a new contract?
Sure, it makes life a lot easier. You know, if you've got the transparency and you've got the honesty, there's no skullduggery going on. They're not trying to, you know, get one up on you on here or there. So it makes it a lot easier. With Arsenal, it was fairly smooth. I think when you've got two parties that both want the same outcome, Ben had done really well for a couple of years. He was very happy there. The club wanted to keep him. But what we did is we're very data and statistics based. So we enlisted a company and paid a fair fee for it to basically compile a report. So it would benchmark Ben for Arsenal, benchmark his value within the market. So we're not just going in there, licking our finger and saying, right, this is what we want because we've heard him and him and him is on that money. We've actually gone there with a structured view, whereas actually it's objective.
You said everyone was happy. He wanted to stay. Arsenal wanted him to stay. But was there ever a stage in these negotiations where you thought, we've hit a bit of a stalemate here. This might not happen.
I never didn't think it wouldn't happen. But you're always going to have some impasse. It's never just going to go so smooth unless they come with, you know, a ridiculous figure and it just gets done. There's always some intricacies that you need to discuss that are maybe things that people from the outside in don't really know or see.
Alex, you know I was going to ask you this question. Look, Ben has been in the headlines, making himself unavailable for England in recent months. Can you share and confirm what that reason was?
It's a difficult one. We've dealt with this in a real private manner and we would like to continue to do so. I mean, there's been a lot said by various different outlets and people, but I think we're going to remain quiet on that.
But just on that, though, I hear, you know, I listen to the radio, I listen to pundits on TV, and everyone seems to have an opinion, particularly when this story came out.
Sure.
Without any real knowledge of what had happened. Mm-hmm. How was Ben when all of this was happening, and how were you?
It's hard because, obviously, you know, in one sense, you want people to hear something so the noise kind of goes away. But we just removed ourselves from the situation. And, you know, there are reasons and they'll be remaining private.
So, remove yourself from the situation. But now, there's a new manager incoming. There's obviously Lee Carsley, who's going to be there in interim charge as well. So, Ben White for England again, potentially?
I think it's all hype. It's all if, buts and maybes. It's just hard to comment at the minute. It's not something we've spoken in depth about. So I suppose kind of wait and see.
I suppose it will come to a pass when the squad is named. And
sure.
If or in the lead up to that squad being named, that's when he'll have to make a decision, because at the moment he doesn't have to, does he?
Exactly. Exactly. I think he's going to focus on Arsenal and hopefully them mounting a title challenge again.
Alex, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much for joining us on the Transfer Show.